project viewer update either tomorrow or the very beginning of next week. We've just sent it off to QA. If QA doesn't crush it, then we'll put it out. We'll put the update out. As far as we know, this is feature complete and has no blocking bugs in it, which means that if a few people will test it and let us know that they haven't found any blocking bugs, we can make it a release candidate, and maybe we can get it out the next few weeks, or at the very least in early January. If we don't get much testing of it, it gets harder for us to be confident that it's ready to for general use. So please keep an eye open for that project viewer update, and please try it out. It should work anywhere now, because the server-side work is all done. We just did a one server-side fix that improved the performance of it significantly. And that seems to be working well. So please watch for that viewer, and please try it out.
You'll be seeing quite a few different viewers coming out with updates now that Animesh has gone to release. You know, it's the usual shuffle where everybody has to merge in the changes. So probably be quite a lot of those showing up if they haven't already.
Yeah, there's a deep queue in QA, but Bakes on Mesh is number 2 in the queue, so should come out quickly.
Yeah, Bakes on Mesh, I believe that this latest build addresses all of the issues that we were planning to tackle for release. So yeah, if everything gets the go-ahead on in testing, and you know, we get good experiences with people trying it out, it's pretty likely that that'll wind up becoming an RC viewer next and go out to a larger audience. Hopefully that's getting close now. Let's see. Ryder, do you want to say anything about where we are with EAP these days?
Sure. I'm getting what I believe is the last of the LSL functions in. And I am in fact looking off at a different window and coding that up as we speak. This will be LL set agent environment, which lets you actually tweak individual parameters for an agent in an experience. And I think that will be close to all of the simulator work that's going to need to be done. And I can return to focusing on getting the last few things into the viewer. The stigma list. Oh yeah, the new viewer will say that among the things that an experience can do is modify your environment. I believe that's what you meant.
Getting close on the graphic side of things as well.
I hope so. I need to corner gram and see where a couple things stand. So I'm hoping we'll have more of that in.
Yeah, sounds good. So that may be about it for updates. So let's see, we've got Animesh, Bakes on Mesh, EAP. We've got the usual you know, sequence of bug fix work going on, you know, various main builds. But I think that may be about it. Anybody has general questions? So here's one about epoxlug. Yeah, does anybody on the Firestorm side of things want to comment on how things are going with Animesh there? How is Animesh development going? I'm curious if any of the folks in this group who have been working on Animesh content have released anything on the marketplace yet. And, you know, if not, are you waiting on the Firestorm release or waiting on something else?
For us, we're probably a month away releasing, just because we could release all the things they have to have.
Those customers can be so demanding. Yeah, I have seen a few things showing up in the marketplace already.
Old horses released, yeah. Imperial horses. I might have to switch to Firestone just for that.
Oh, it looks nice. Lucy, we're doing some looking now at the queue for, you know, requested work, and don't have a final answer on that, but if, you know, things like that that are kind of self-contained and, you know, pretty straightforward, I think there's a decent chance we can fit the follow-on project. We'll have to, anything with LSL, we decide exactly what. Hopefully we can tackle some of those things. Yeah, new materials is a tougher question. That's, you know, that's a big project, and we've got a lot of demands on our rendering time these days. So can't say anything definite about that right now. Which aspects of materials are you most interested in, and is there a JIRA about those aspects? Anyway, if there are particular aspects that folks are especially interested in, it's always a good idea to file a JIRA about that. Even if we can't act on it right away, the fact that it's in the queue somewhere makes it a lot easier to keep track of it and to point to it. And whenever we do get some cycles, we can say, oh, hey, we should take a look at this thing. Whereas if we're just trying to remember what somebody asked about 6 months ago, All right, well, we're open for any other questions. If there's nothing else, we can call an early meeting. Right now I'm working on some kind of under the hood stuff, trying to make it easier to update the library inventory, which is something that's doesn't get done very often because it's kind of hard to do. And after that I'm hoping to get started on some I've been calling low-hanging fruit projects, things that aren't as elaborate as something like the full Animesh project, but that address some of the more straightforward things that we've been talking about from there or from other places. Yeah, I don't know about the lost attachments. It's certainly something that I understand there's quite a bit of concern about, although it doesn't sound like it's a new thing. It's more of a kind of an ongoing issue. Texture cache is something that Graham's been looking for time to work on, but he's been pretty much 100% on EAP lately, so it's kind of gated on that.
You might want to hold off on integrating any changes to the texture cache because we've got a completely, essentially a complete rewrite in the wings.
Oh, I was just going to ask. I think I've seen my own texture on my avatar reload 6 times already.
If what you mean is, do we know how long till we put that out in public? Shouldn't be very long, actually. Again, that's another one of Graham's projects, so it's behind EAP at the moment.
Did want to bring up to the other creators that plan on ever selling anything in Sansar to have account in Sansar by December 4th to qualify for the grandfathering after the Steam release. The cash out will be $250.01 for if you get in before. It'll be 140 something to 1. Yes, so for some reason they couldn't get Steam to come down from there.
Oh, yeah, thanks for putting in those links.
I'm not sure. Our time. I haven't cashed out any.
Be associated with some kind of meme about Ruth Coin. What is full perm with commission? Do they just do it at the level of reselling whole items, or do they do the kind of component by component stuff like they do in Sensor? Just like I think they do in Sensor.
Yeah, they just put it out. Take somebody else's item, add something. But you always pay their cost. Well, you just can't item together. But first, they think it's pretty brilliant. You guys seen the uptick yet? Well,
yeah, I haven't heard anything about that. I mean, it's pretty
early. Premium membership has been growing since we changed the land benefits. So it's not clear that we would be able to see the difference between that and between the growth that's already happening and the and anything induced by anime. Be nice.
Well, that's good that it's growing.
Very.
Yeah, the idea of a commission system is very cool. In terms of Second Life, anytime you're saying, well, we need to change it, just involves changing the permission system and everything you can do with objects. In World, it's going to be a bit of a reach. Couldn't see that being anything tackling near term right now. We would change permissions. We usually hide under the furniture. Lucy, you say owner after next. This isn't an chain where you have to specify all stages, right? It's just got the kind of three categories. Could you talk about that a little more? Why do we care specifically about the difference between? Okay. So it's full perm, except that you don't have permissions to change the permissions. Well, that's interesting. Yeah, I'm hoping that things like Bakes on Mesh will reduce the need for full perm items, but that goes.
Now, Veer, some of the, I know just recently, Lyndon Rounds put out a new. Do you guys open up some of that stuff for kind of make their own version?
The plan actually is to open source all the LSL for Lyndon Rounds for the latest version. I am in the process of reviewing that to make sure that we haven't accidentally put anything in it that shouldn't be public. So the idea is to put it out there as a working example for people to follow and critique and so on. But it's actually on my plate to finish that review. So
I'd like to see us do do more of that over time. Of course, it's not experience stuff, but we did try to do that with the Animesh sample content as well. Put it out in a forum that people could actually get to the source files and show them how they wanted to.
No, I think it's definitely the lab putting out those source files is definitely a good road.
That is our hope. And just having good working examples of how to use lots of the LSL calls.
Yeah, anything where we can reduce the barriers to entry for content creation. All right. Well, I guess we're about at time. We can probably wrap it up for this week. Next week, we do not have a meeting because we've got our usual conflicting company same time slot. And I think after that, we'll be back on a regular schedule until we start getting into the holiday break season. So I'll update the schedule on that. And see everybody in a couple of weeks.
Sure.
No, thanks, everybody. Bye.